cereal as well. All you have to if you want to ring to win is answer the following question, which is, how many goals did Michael Owen score in this year's World Cup?
I don't know.
Is it A, 2, B, 6, or C, 8?
If you think you know the answer, call us on 0901 070 9090. Calls cost 30 pence. And remember to mission before you dial.
But right now it's fun to catch up with Miss Buffy herself,
Sarah Michelle Gellar, and her real-life boyfriend, Freddie Prinze Jr.
Here's part two of our exclusive report. Freddie does have a point. The blonde's got a goal.
I know.
But nice. Still to come on today's SSM TV Live big movie special, we'll be bringing you the first glimpse ever of the brand new Austin Powers movie. American Pie Movies will be telling us all about his new action movie, Rollerball.
And coming next, we'll be putting your emails to George from Stuart Little 2, Hollywood movie star Jonathan Lipnicki, who's here to tell us all about the sequel. See you in a few minutes. Welcome back to SMTV Live, Big Movie Special. Our next guest, right, listen to this, has played Tom Cruise's son, a vampire, and the brother of a mouse, and he's only 11 years old. Aww. You can see him next in the sequel to Stuart Little, which is in cinemas later this month. But before we meet the boy in action, before we meet the boy, let's see him in action. Jonathan, how are you?
Great.
Little ho.
Yeah.
Now, we all love the first Stuart Little movie. Tell us a bit about the sequel. What's it about?
Well, it's about George, my character. He makes a winning soccer goal, as you saw in that trailer. And he's really popular. He gets all these friends. And it kind of just leaves Stuart behind. Stuart then gets his own friend, this bird named Margot. Who gets kidnapped and he has to
No!
Oh, no!
It's very exciting.
Has anything changed since the first film?
Well, I'm 3 years older.
That always helps.
With a broken foot as well?
Yeah, well,
oh, I did that later.
Come on. Oh.
But is Snowbell still as mischievous as was before?
Well, he's a little nicer. He's Stuart's friend now.
That's good. Yeah. That's good. So, have you got a favourite scene from the movie?
Well, I got the scene, it's a blooper actually, and I was running up the stairs after I lied, to cover up for Stuart going to get his friend. I was running up and tripped over and I rolled all the way back down the stairs.
Oh no!
Did you yourself?
Oh no!
Nope, I just was a bit dizzy.
Brave lad.
What? What's like acting with a mouse? Is it, do you actually see Stuart when he's there? Is there anything there?
I'm just talking to a piece of tape.
Laser.
Or a model of Stuart. Nothing really there.
Oh, that's a shame. I thought he'd be there.
Do you find that difficult to do?
Or is it quite easy? It's pretty difficult.
It's not real. Sorry.
How do you remember all your lines?
Well, it's coming easier now that I've been doing more movies, but it can be hard sometimes. Yeah. Long scenes, but I usually practice 2 scenes at a time.
Yeah? Could you give Brian a few tips?
You know, I knew today was just going too easy.
Never mind. Actually, what we've got another clip for you, so let's take a look.
Stuart! What are you doing?
I'm not doing anything!
Hold the brake! Get the book!
Sir, on takeoff!
Pull back on the throttle!
Take off! I'm in the air!
Get out of the way!
Please, don't hurt me.
Oh,
snowball there running for his life.
Yeah.
Now, you were only 6 when you made your acting debut.
6.
As Tom Cruise's stepson, Jeremy Maguire. Was that scary?
Well, everyone was really down to earth. They're really nice. So it wasn't really that scary because they're all really nice.
Were you not nervous going to work?
I was a little nervous, but then after them being nice, I assured it was going to be great.
Yeah. So which film did you most enjoy filming?
Well, kind of like apples and oranges. They both have their reasons. I really like them.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Is there anybody that you, in Hollywood, would just really love to star with? Maybe not even in Hollywood.
Maybe Russell Crowe.
Why would you like to star with Russell Crowe?
Well, he's just great. He's a brilliant actor.
He's a tough guy, isn't he?
Yeah.
What are you doing now after Stuart Little 2? Have you got any more movies you're filming?
Well, I have Like Mike coming out in December with Bow Wow. And,
cool.
I'm filming a movie in the fall called When Zachary Beaver Came to Town. It's from a book.
Yeah?
It's with the director from Like Mike.
And how long are you in London for?
Till Tuesday, yeah.
Till Tuesday?
Yeah.
Cool, so we're in for a treat, don't
we? London's really trendy.
All the shops are really good.
And now, Michael J. Fox and Melanie Griffiths do voices in the film, don't they?
Yep.
Did you get to meet them at all?
I didn't meet Michael in the first one. I met him on the second one at the end. And Melanie, I met her in the beginning at a table read, which is like a rehearsal.
Mm-hmm. Well, Jonathan, I'll tell you what, the best of luck with the film.
Thank you.
You know, we wish you all the best. Jonathan Lipnicki, everyone.
Yeah!
Is out in cinemas from July the 19th, rather. And Jonathan will be joining the Big Brother housemates at 10 past 11 this morning.
Ooh.
So stay tuned for that. Now from Hollywood movie stars to Hollywood movie star aliens, it's the Men in Black!
Yeah.
Exclusive first look at the new Austin Powers movie, but we also have the actual costumes used in the film.
They are so valuable, we're only allowed to wear them for a few seconds. It must be very, very careful.
Nice. I'm wearing the Dr. Evil costume, and Brian's wearing none other than Austin Powers.
Yeah, baby, yeah.
And Max here is wearing Mini-Me. Look, he's our very own Mini-Me.
Mini-Max.
Wearing the priceless silk outfit that Beyonce from Destiny's Child wears as Foxy Cleopatra, it's Claire Richards.
Sorry, guys, I haven't had my breakfast yet, so I'm just gonna.
You want to put that outfit with what's not
No, but I haven't had my breakfast.
Claire, you have to put it down.
Calm your lips.
To Sirius Skydive! I'll take it to the laundry and see what they can do.
No, let me soak it first.
It needs to go to the laundry.
Not before it's been soaked.
That's torn it. He's part one of today's pop stars. It's time to choose the final 3 members. And or do they? One of today's finalists dropped some bombshell news part to a pop star's later, so you'd be a fool to miss it.
I'm off to the shops.
So I mean, I'll ask everybody with a brain back here in a couple of minutes for the lowdown on Chris Klein's new action movie Rollerball. For the Lulu. Welcome back to SMTV Live's big movie special.
Yay!
Now then, there's a new action movie in cinemas at the moment called Rollerball.
Rollerball.
Yes, it stars the hunky Chris Klein, who played Oz in American Pie, rapper LL Cool J and Mystique from the X-Men. The film is packed with thrills and spills, and our test went to find out more.
I mean, she can't make it into work on the Saturday morning, but she can go and interview a Hollywood superstar.
MacGyver.
I'm not happy about this. There'll be words. Now, we promised
to a shock in the second part of today's Irish Pop Stars. Get ready, folks, we're about to deliver this. Shortly after six members of the band moved into the house together, there was, dun dun dun, a scandalous revelation. So big was this scandal, thanks Bronwyn, that it was front page news in every paper all over Ireland. It made the TV news and a massive 70% of
what
the population tuned in to see what you're about to see happen next. Sit down, be quiet, and watch. Scandalous was that. So Nadine Cole was dumped from the band for being underage, and back home in Ireland it caused a scandal in the press and on TV. We've been joined by the girl who wanted it so badly she spent almost a day sticking to her story that she was 18. Please welcome Miss Nadine Cole, everyone.
Now, Nadine, how on earth did you think you were going to get away with it?
I didn't. I never thought. When I went to the first audition, I thought, oh no, I'll not get past this next round. So I thought, I'll just do it, no, just for a laugh, they say I done it. And got past again, and again, and again. I thought, what's going on here? And so I never ever expected to get past the first one. Never expected the lie for the length of time.
But it wasn't just a little lie, it was a big black one, wasn't it? What you like?
What's the public reaction been to what happened?
It's been brilliant. In Ireland, I've had so much support. You know, people coming up in the streets and saying, oh, you done the right thing, and I would have done it, and good luck, and all things like that.
So. On your time on Popstars, how did you feel every time the judges reminded you that you had to be over 18?
They didn't. Age was only mentioned one time, and that was when I first went there. When I first went there for the very first audition, I didn't know you had to be over 18 until I had to sign a form. And it said, you must be over 18 to go on to the next round. And I thought, oh, I'm not going to get past, so I'll just sign it anyway. So I signed it, and then when I got past, I said, if I get through the next round, I'll tell them. If I get through the next, I'll tell them.
On the final 32, did they not ask in the room, was there anyone, and was everyone over 18?
Is everyone in the room over 18? And I just...
I think we're actually just going to show a clip now, actually, where you were confronted. So we'll see it again.
We're trying to make out that you were 18, that you were, would you tell me at this stage?
I would tell you at this stage.
As your friend?
I would tell you. It's totally right, I think.
Now, when you look at that, do you
feel bad for telling lies?
I feel stupid. I feel gone. Oh my God.
And do you not feel bad for lying on national television for so long?
Well, it did last for long. That bit from this first happened to when it came out wasn't that length. Was a long time at all. It was like a month or so. So, and we didn't see them all the time. So it was just like that week away when I wasn't really asked about my age or anything. And then I just thought
but
when
surely,
it came out.
But surely when you applied, you obviously told your parents. And were they behind you?
They
telling,
were behind
telling
they,
the lie mm-hmm. the whole time.
Mm-hmm. They said, if you want to do this, we're behind you doing it. You know what I mean? If you want to drop out now and leave it, they told me what could be the consequences. They said, you know, it could be pop star's liar and, you know, Nadine's a liar and all this kind of thing. And I said, no, she'll not get to that stage. It'll make a big deal.
Yeah, and you said that the public were being genuinely nice to you.
Mm-hmm.
But has anyone been nasty to you? Have you had anything bad for telling lies on national television?
Not at all. You get any time you're mentioned on the papers or whatever, it's always, you know, look, pop star's liar, or, you know, Nadine, you know, things like that, but you just get
Well, not the headlines, is that what they were?
That's
say, for example, if you had been knocked out in the first two stages for being only 16,
mm-hmm.
and then you've seen someone else get through
mm-hmm.
and went to the stage, how would you have felt about that? From a viewer's point of view, how would you have felt?
If I was a viewer watching somebody done what I've done.
And someone done what you've done, how would you feel, honestly?
Well, honestly, I would have done it myself if I was a viewer. Because I did do it, so I would say, you know.
But you don't see anything wrong with telling the lie, do you? But you seem justified that what you've done was the right thing to do.
Feels very strongly about this, can you tell?
I think I've done the right thing. I was happy I'd done it. Myself, you know what I mean? I'm not proud of having the lie about my age. I wish it had been 16, but it wasn't. And because of what I'd done, I met loads of brilliant people and all that, so.
How did you feel when you slipped up? Was it butterflies or was it a triumphant?
No, it was butterflies. More, yeah. I just thought, oh my God, I wanted to actually tell them myself. Be able to say, right, you know, I'm in this band. I never thought I would get here, but I'm only 16.
It's very quiet in the studio, by the way. It's very serious.
Scandal.
So what have you got coming up? What's in line for you now?
Louis Walsh just managed me. He manages Westlife.
Louis the king in Ireland. King of music.
Samantha Mumba, and so him, and hopefully I'll be getting on the studio now soon. They start,
so it came good in the end.
There's loads more of Nadine Coyle.
Nadine, thank you for coming in.
Thanks so much.
Don't make you that bad. Nadine Coyle, everyone.
Well done, Nadine.
And you can see how Nadine's parents sick.
And you can also find out who takes the place in the band in Pop Stars next week on SSM TV Live.
We'll see you in a couple of minutes for Big Bother.